हेलो फ्रेंड्स, बीएमएस ऑर्गेन के यूट्यूब चैनल के आज के अपने इस वीडियो में मैं इमरान अहमद आप सभी का स्वागत करता हूं। दोस्तों, मैं उम्मीद करता हूं आप सभी अच्छे होंगे। दोस्तों, अगर अभी तक आपने हमारे यूट्यूब चैनल बीएमएस ऑर्गेन को सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया है तो कृपया चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन को दबाएँ, जिससे हमारे द्वारा दी गई वीडियो आप तक आसानी से पहुँच सके। और हाँ दोस्तों, हमारे फेसबुक पेज, इंस्टाग्राम पेज और टेलीग्राम चैनल से जुड़ना ना भूलें। हमें सर्च करें बीएमएस ऑर्गेन। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज मीजल्स। दिस वीडियो इज प्रेजेंटेड बाय डॉक्टर खुशबू मिश्रा। प्लीज लाइक, कमेंट्स एंड शेयर विथ योर फ्रेंड्स।
हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे विल बी डिस्कसिंग ऑन टॉपिक मीजल्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज मीजल्स। मीजल्स इज एन अक्यूट हाईली कम्युनिकेबल वायरल डिजीज विथ फीवर, कंजंक्टिवाइटिस, कुराइजा, कफ एंड स्मॉल स्पॉट नोन एज कॉप्लिक स्पॉट, which are white or bluish white in color, which appear onto the base of the buccal mucosa. So let's understand what is measles. Measles is an acute, that means it is infectious disease. Along with that, it is highly communicable in the sense it spreads very rapidly to other person. If one patient is suffering from the measles, if some other person comes in contact with that patient, so it will be spreading very rapidly. Along with that, it is viral disease, that is, it means that this disease, measles disease, is caused by virus, so it is viral disease. So what are associated symptoms with the measles? If someone is suffering from the measles, that person will be having fever, conjunctivitis in the sense redness of the eyes, that is inflammation of the eyes, coryza, that is cold and cough that person will be suffering from, and small spots known as coplic spots will be appearing onto the buccal mucosa. So the lower teeth, we have premolar and molar teeth, and between these two premolar and molar teeth, there will be coplic spots which will be appearing in the gums of the premolar and molar teeth, which are known as coplic spots, and these coplic spots will be white or bluish in color. So this was all about measles introduction. Now what are causative agent, matlab how is the measles caused? It is caused by a virus known as measles virus, and this measles virus belong to genus morbillivirus. And family, what is the family of measles virus? It is paramyxoviridae, which is the family of measles. I repeat again, measles is caused by a virus known as measles virus. It is caused, which genus does it belong to? It belongs to morbillivirus, and family paramyxoviridae. Source of infection, how does this measles virus or measles disease spread? It is spread from the patient suffering from the measles to other person. So the patient suffering from measles itself are the source of infection. If some patient is suffering from measles, if some other persons or people come in contact with the patient, so that other people will also be prone to be getting this same type of disease. So this is how the measles disease or measles virus spread. How does it spread? Mainly by droplet infection. Droplet infection, which means if the patient who is suffering from measles actually speaks, or if he talks, what does is nothing but he delivers the saliva, which enters the other person who is standing in front of him. It enters the person's respiratory tract by air passage. This is how the measles virus spread. So it is spread by droplet infection and a droplet nuclei. So spitting out the saliva, that is the main source of droplet. So this is how the measles virus, they entered the other person's respiratory tract or air passage. Incubation period. Now what is incubation period? From the time of infection to appearance of onset of disease is referred to as incubation period. The period from the time when the infection enters the body and its body starts showing signs and symptoms, that total period time is known as incubation period. And incubation period for the measles is 10 to 14 days. What are signs and symptoms associated with the measles? First is pre-eruptive stage, eruptive stage and post-measles stage. That is, we have divided the signs and symptoms into three stages. The initial stage or initial phase of the appearance of signs and symptoms is referred to as pre-eruptive stage. सेकेंड इज इरप्टिव स्टेज वेर दी कंडीशंस बिकम स्लाइट सिवियर और लिटिल क्रिटिकल एंड थर्ड इज नथिंग बट पोस्ट मीजल स्टेज दैट इज दिस इज रिफर्ड टू एज रिकवरी फेज वेर इन द पेशेंट स्टार्ट्स रिकवरिंग स्लोली स्लोली सो लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड दी साइंस एंड सिम्टम्स इन डिटेल. First is pre-eruptive stage. Pre-eruptive stage is characterized by fever. That means initially the patient who is suffering from measles may get fever. He may get coryza, that is cold and cough with sneezing and nasal discharge. He may get cough and redness of the eyes. Lacrimation, that is continuous. There'll be falling of tears as well as photophobia. That person will be finding difficulty in observing the sunlight. So photophobia, this is pre-eruptive stage. Along with that, there'll be appearance of rash in the rash known as coplic spot. That means we have already discussed what is coplic spot. Special type of it is spot which appears and between the first and second molar of the lower teeth and the buccal mucosa. These spots are nothing but they are bluish or whitish in color. So this coplic spots will be appearing in the pre-eruptive stage. Appearance of rash coplic spots which are like table salt. These coplic spots will be very tiny, that they are referred to as, they are given they are told as to be like table salt crystals appear onto the buccal mucosa. They'll be appearing onto the buccal mucosa, that is buccal cavity teeth mucosa region, opposite the first and second lower molars. So opposite to the first and second lower molars, you'll be having these coplic spots. They are whitish, matlab they will be whitish spots or bluish spots, or they'll be tiny onto the red base, smaller than the head of the pin. Now second stage is eruptive stage, wherein the condition becomes slight critical. It is characterized by eruption of the rashes. So rashes will be appearing. These rashes are red, macular or maculopapular, which begins behind the ears. This rashes will be starting right from the ears onwards, and it will be spreading to the whole body, face, necks, and extend down the body into 2 to 3 days. Matlab, within 2 to 3 days, the whole body will be full of rashes. Post measles stage is nothing but in this phase, the child will have loss of weight. Matlab, continuously because of facing this measles, the patient will become, the child will become really weak. He will have weight loss. He will become very weak for few days. There'll be growth retardation also aware then. Besides that, you may have some complications like diarrhea, cancrum or eyes, pyogenic infections and presence of opportunistic infections along with measles. And later on, after this, all these things, this child starts to recover on 21st to 23rd day onwards. So we don't need any treatment. Soon after 21st to 23 days onwards, the child will start recovering and rashes starts to disappear. Sometimes complications also occur, that means along with the measles disease, there will be some other complications associated with the measles. The most common complications are measles associated diarrhea, pneumonia and other respiratory complications and otitis media. What a diagnostic investigation. How can you detect the measles? Presence of typical rash, that means physically how can you determine the person is suffering from the measles, that is appearance of the rashes and coplic spots into the oral mucosa. Then sometimes specific IgM antibodies testing is also used for diagnosis. Treatment. How can you treat? There is no such treatment for the measles till now. Only symptomatic treatment is needed for the signs and symptoms. So we don't require any treatment. It just disappears after 21st to 23rd day. So no treatment as such is required. Just symptomatic treatment should be given. Like for example, if the patient is suffering from coryza and fever and also that treatment should be given instead of treating the whole measles. Vitamin A supplementation is given at the time of measles diagnosis. Main attention is given to prevent the disease. So treatment is nothing but preventing the disease itself becomes the main treatment. How can you prevent it? By vaccination. Vaccination is the best system to prevent the disease, measles. Measles vaccine is available as the measles only vaccine or in combination with the rubella as MR or with the rubella and mumps as the MMR, that is measles, mumps, rubella vaccine. So individually also measles is available, along with the rubella also measles vaccine is available. First dose is given at the 9 months. So first dose of measles is given at the 9 months and second dose is given at 15 months. This is very important. They may ask in Viva also. First dose of measles is given at which months? 9 months and second is 15 months. रिपोर्टिंग एंड नोटिफिकेशन प्रोवाइड्स अपॉर्चुनिस्टिक फॉर बेटर आउटब्रेक कंट्रोल. सो if there is any outbreak of this condition, so it should be taken into notification and thus preventive measures should be taken to spread the outburst of this disease. Children with measles should, if practicable, be kept away from the school for 4 days after appearance. If soon the child is getting rashes into the whole body, so that child should be kept away from the school, so in order to prevent the other children from getting this type of disease.